All right, 11th, we are to continue with the if function that we did yesterday, okay? The offline students, open Python on your computer and type the program parallel to me. Right?
Yes, sir.
So we start with the simple program and we'll be proceeding to the technical ones, right? So the first program which we practice today is to find the greatest among two numbers, right? So we'll be putting the concept of if else. We'll be checking the condition using if. If the condition evaluates to true, the statement associated with the true part will get executed. But if the condition is false, the statement associated with the else part will get executed. Either the true part will run, either the else part will run. Both will not run together. And statement within the if function are indented. Normal statement in Python is not indented. But when you create a block, the statements are indented inside the block till you break the indentation. Any statement again written normally after the indented statements, that is not treated as a part of block. Am I clear? So let us start. X variable equal to, I am inputting the variable integer, enter the value of X. Okay. Then I have Y variable and I input the value of Y variable. Clear? First of all, I print the normal variables. Okay. Normally, I print the X and Y variable. Now here I put the condition, if X more than Y, if X more than Y, colon, where you put colon in Python, from there the block starts. That indicates that block is starting here. Now all the statements which I will type now, they will be indented. Offline class, see the LCD. As I press the enter key after putting the colon, see the position of the cursor. Automatically, the statement will be indented because they are the part of block. Jab bhi aap colon daloge, wahan se block shuru hoga. Right? Now here I type print. X is greatest. Right? Then again, shift the cursor at the back and place the else block. Now else block will start. The statements which are part of else block, they will start. Print. Y is greatest, right? Y is greatest. Clear?
Yes, sir.
Now, if I type one more sentence here, print, finally, code ends. Till I break the indentation, the statements are the part of else block. You check this print statement, Y is greatest, and you check this print statement, finally code ends. Both are indented. Both are indented. You know what is indentation?
Yes, sir.
away from the margin, away from the margin. Now these two statements are indented, indented under the else block. So they are part of else block. If condition fails, these two statements will get executed.
Yes.
Let us save the code and run it. Then I will make changes in this code only. I'm making one folder here for plus one programs. Plus one programs, flow of control. I give the name if function. Right? Let us run it. Enter the value of x 10. Enter the value of y 5. See, first of all, x and y are printed normally. Then if condition is checked, condition was true. 10 more than 5, condition evaluates to true. So message x is greatest is printed. Clear?
Yes, sir.
I can set one empty line in between so that output becomes more clear. Okay. Again, I run it. This time I give X as 10, Y as 20. Now check it out. When the condition goes fail, when the condition goes fail, the else part will run. In the else part, two statements were associated. So both the statements are printed as result. Clear?
Yes. Sir, the second statement of finally gold and go open is to the x is greater than 1. So, x is a print of
the. Yes. The number of statements associated with the true part or else part, they all will run. Agar true part mein teen statements hai, और कंडीशन ट्रू हो गई वो तीनों प्रिंट होंगी स्टेटमेंट्स. सिमिलरली इन द एल्स पार्ट यू हैव फोर स्टेटमेंट्स एंड एल्स पार्ट हैज बिकम करेक्ट तो ऑल द फोर विल रन. राइट? ऑनलाइन क्लास एम आई क्लियर टू ऑल? रमनजीत एम आई क्लियर टू यू? यस रमनजीत 11th बी एम आई क्लियर? Now, I make another program. This was the comparison. Now, I go with the another program. I just make changes here only by specifying the boat. The program is input the age of any person and check if the person is eligible for vote or not. Okay? And check if the person is eligible for vote or not. Clear? So I make change here. I input the age of person. Let the variable be age. You can take any variable you want. Okay? Display the age of the person. Age equal to age. Okay. If age more than equal to 18, as per the rights, 18 years and above 18 years is eligible for vote. So that is why I have put the condition over here, age more than equal to 18. If I write age more than 18, suppose you enter 18, it will not pick it up. It will say you are not eligible for vote. But 18 wala bhi to eligible hai. तो 18 वाले के लिए हमने इक्वल टू साइन डाल दिया. एम आई क्लियर आशुतोष? इफ एज मोर देन इक्वल टू 18, प्रिंट पर्सन इज एलिजिबल. पर्सन इज एलिजिबल. ओके. एंड इफ एज इज लेस देन 18, इन द एल्स पार्ट वी विल राइट पर्सन इज नॉट एलिजिबल. पर्सन इज नॉट एलिजिबल. बेटे कॉन्सेप्ट इज क्लियर? बी वेरी लॉजिकल इन डूइंग दिस चैप्टर. डोंट ट्राई टू क्रैम द प्रोग्राम्स. वन थिंग, 11th क्लास ऑनलाइन यू ऑल्सो लिसन, डोंट ट्राई टू क्रैम द प्रोग्राम. ट्राई टू बिल्ड योर लॉजिक्स. ट्राई टू इंक्रीज योर प्रोग्रामिंग स्किल्स. लॉजिक बनाओ पहले. सोचो मुझे यहां पर क्या प्लॉटिंग करनी है कि मेरा ये लॉजिक क्रिएट हो जाए. The more you will go with the cramming, the more you will face problem in coding. Because at the later stage, you have to create the project. And project will be created if you are very much expert in source code. Okay? And don't depend ki bas teacher ne logic karaya, wohi correct. If you have some good logic that you can apply, like in maths, you have so many methods to do the sum. Similarly, in programming, you can apply your own logic also, but logic should be correct. Okay? Yes. Online class, any doubt in this coding? Let us run the code. Enter the... ये block है बेटे. This is block. The portion which I have shared, this is block. This is block. उसके अंदर दो ब्लॉक हो गए ना, एक ट्रू ब्लॉक एक फॉल्स ब्लॉक. ओके, लिसन हेयर, आई टाइप वन स्टेटमेंट हेयर, प्रिंट वोटिंग एंड्स. ओके, now enter age. I say age 16. Person is not eligible. Beta, please see the LCD first of light class. Person is not eligible. Voting ends. Why voting end is coming? See here. Condition goes fail. Condition fail ho gayi. Hum aage else wale part pe. Else वाला पार्ट प्रिंट हो गया. हेयर वी आर नॉट डूइंग एनी इंडेंटेशन. हेयर वी आर अगेन टू द नॉर्मल स्टेटमेंट. वी हैव नॉट क्रिएट एनी इंडेंटेड स्टेटमेंट हेयर. सो दिस इज अ नॉर्मल स्टेटमेंट. इट विल वर्क वेदर कंडीशन इज ट्रू, वेदर कंडीशन इज फॉल्स. दिस स्टेटमेंट विल गेट प्रिंट. सपोज कंडीशन गेट ट्रू, चेक इट आउट हेयर. I just close the initial run window. I have age 19. See, person is eligible, voting ends. Voting ends is the normal statement, right? Yes. Am I clear to all? Himanshu, bete aapko, that girl clear? Ashutosh, Japanjot, Gurjot. ऑनलाइन स्टूडेंट्स, दिया, हिमांशु अरोड़ा, रमनजीत, एज आई अनाउंस योर नेम रेज योर थंब सो दैट आई कैन फील योर प्रेजेंस इन द ऑनलाइन क्लास. यशिका, रिद्धि, कॉन्सेप्ट इज क्लियर? आर्यमन सैनी, दिवनूर, असीस, Okay. All right, let us go with another program. These are the programs that you have to type in your practical file also. So please note down the question. Please note down the question for the practical file also, students. Write a program to input age of a person and check if he is eligible for vote or not. Okay. Now I make the changes. Now I create the program of if comparison. Shall I start the next question now?
Yes.
All right. Now the concept is, I have an organization and I am to give salary to the employees. I have some structure of the payment of salary. You are to input the salary of a person basic salary. You are to input basic salary of a person. If the basic salary of a person is more than 20,000, then HRA should be 20% of salary. HRA is house rent allowance. एक एम्प्लॉय की सैलरी कैसे बनती है? बेसिक सैलरी एचआरए डीए माइनस प्रोविडेंट फंड. प्रोविडेंट फंड इज सम अमाउंट रिटेन फॉर योर फ्यूचर. तो डेली लॉयंस. ओके, एचआरए 20% ऑफ द सैलरी, डीए इज 15% ऑफ द सैलरी. If salary is more than 20,000, HRA is 20%, DA is 15%. Whenever you encounter the percentage symbol, you are to do calculation. If salary is less than equal to 20,000, then HRA should be 15% and DA should be 10% of the basic salary. Then finally, you are to find the net salary. Net salary should be basic salary plus HRA plus DA. I hope the question is clear to all.
Yes.
So let us frame the coding. Side by side, I will explain you. Okay. First of all, we are to input the basic salary. So I am taking the variable basic. You can take any variable. I am inputting the salary of floor type. Enter the salary. Okay. Right. Now, if basic more than 20,000, if basic is more than 20,000, then beta, please see here now. Offline class, please check the LCD. Yes. How to perform the calculation? What is HRA? 20% of basic, 0.20 into basic. Don't write this. Many students, they write like this. This is wrong. You have to calculate the 20% of it. Okay.
Yes, sir.
I am not creating else part right now because HRA and DA both have to be calculated. What is DA? 15% of basic. ये तो हो गया अगर सैलरी 20 से ज्यादा है. एल्स सुनो इधर, अगर ये कंडीशन सेटिस्फाई नहीं होती, वो 20 से ज्यादा नहीं है, ऑटोमेटिकली मींस एल्स में वो 20 से कम है या 20 के बराबर है. यू गेट इट, यू गेट माई पॉइंट ऑनलाइन क्लास. इफ इन द ट्रू कंडीशन द कंडीशन फेल्स, इट ऑटोमेटिकली मींस सैलरी इज आइदर लेस देन 20 और 20 बट नॉट मोर देन 20. सो स्ट्रेट अवे व्हाट विल बी द एचआरए इफ कंडीशन फेल्स? 15% ऑफ बेसिक. डीए विल बी 10% ऑफ बेसिक. कम आउट ऑफ द ब्लॉक. Finally, you are to find the net salary. Net salary is basic plus HRA plus DA. Okay? HRA plus DA. Now print. First of all, print the basic salary. Okay? Right? This is basic. Then print HRA. This will print the HRA. Then print DA. Then print the net salary. Net salary. Right? Am I clear online class? Ramanjeet, is the coding clear? Yes, online or offline class? Enter the salary. I am entering 22,000. Check it out. Check the result online class. Now I change the scenario. I enter the salary less than 20,000. I enter 18,000. Now check. Depending upon the salary structure, the calculations are being performed. Accordingly, net salary has been calculated. Am I clear, students? Yes. Online class, is the complete code clear? Yes, online class. Any doubt? Okay. One concept which I explained yesterday, I'm repeating again. Suppose I have if basic. I am not putting any less than sign, greater than sign, equal to sign. I am simply saying basic. Simply, I am putting one variable after the if function. It means if the variable is non-zero. If the variable is non-zero, the condition is true. Wo non-zero hona chahiye. If you have only the variable name written after the if function, that means the variable should have non-zero value. Agar wo zero hai, to wo else part mein chala jayega. Agar wo non-zero hai, to wo true part mein jayega. Is the concept clear?
Yes.
All right.